Welcome to the Salisbury Link Coming Together Through Sport program. Over the coming months, the City of Salisbury will be working with local sporting clubs and providing opportunities for people from new and emerging communities to participate in sport and recreation activities in Salisbury.
My name's Paul Zimney, the Sports Development Officer for the City of Salisbury. The Salisbury Links program is a great initiative of the council, where we've secured some federal funding through the Department of Immigration. And we're certainly looking to work with both community groups in the Salisbury area, our community sporting clubs, and also our new and emerging communities that are entering in Salisbury.
Basically, Salisbury Link, coming together through sport, will support newly arrived families to engage in recreation opportunities and provide local sporting clubs break down the barriers to participation and get more people involved in your clubs. Salisbury's got a massive influx of new and emerging communities, so to get them involved in a sport is a way of integrating them in the community and breaking down those barriers and, I guess, just making your club more culturally inclusive.
When I was in Nepal, I don't have sufficient facilities, so it's too difficult for us to play to get some facilities. But here, as we arrived here in Australia, we get so many facilities, and it's quite good.
It benefits to our players because actually we used to play with some other players who came from different country, like Burmese, like Afghani. We used to play with them before. We didn't get any chance to play with the players of this particular club, but now we get a chance to play with the players of the established club. It's very good for our players.
Sport has always been a passion for the Bhutanese. I still remember the days when I started playing soccer in my childhood. Like, we didn't have balls. We bring papers, plastic and ropes, just tie it up, make a circular round, a ball-like thing, and wherever we find the place, a field or a ground, we go there and play. And still, when we came to the refugee camps in Nepal, we got engaged with a lot of sporting events like this. There used to be a camp level tournament for soccer. That is a tournament between different refugee camps. And also within the refugee camps, there was a sector, different sectors where a camp was managed. And we used to have a sporting tournament, especially in terms of soccer, within the different sectors of the camp. Also within the between different schools. And now, when we came to Australia, we found this area, the sport, the best one to where we can engage youths and socialize with the people here. It also helps us to integrate with the Australian wider community.
We've been training the Bhutanese community as part of the Lynx project down here just before Christmas. We did about a 6-week program with them, just teaching them not only about soccer but also about the club environments and basically what Powerful Gardens, our club here, can help them with as well. Probably for the last 10 years we've had a very strong junior development program down here, and we have a lot of kids that have come now into the club, whether it be Sudanese or many other African groups who are also new arrivals here. So we've been sort of introducing these groups to our club for many years now, and with the Bhutanese community recently coming here, and we've pretty well embraced what it all. So I guess we're a bit of a multicultural club, and happy to help out in that way.
Me and my brother have been here 2 years. with Danny helped us join the club. Since then, it's been a great experience for me and Ali. We enjoyed it to the maximum. Danny's helped us. You know, they have great people here that take care of you. You know, show you disciplines of the game, everything like that. And they're great people to be around. Me and Ali couldn't enjoy it. It's a great club. I'd recommend it for everyone.
Well, we're the Redbacks Basketball Club. We, as a club, want to be involved with the community as much as we can to promote basketball within the area, to get people involved within the area, get communities involved with the area, and get as much multicultural aspect in basketball itself within the area. The Redbacks Basketball Club itself can provide a lot of areas within the community itself. I mean, obviously we're going to get kids that will become new friends with new people. We're going to get obviously skill development side of things. We're going to get kids that will eventually grow up to become future basketball players of Australia, I hope. And then, you know, just in general get the community involved with our club. We, the Redbacks, want to get involved as much with the Salisbury community as we can, because we want to bring up the future players of Australia. So by having great coaches within the club, helping everybody out, achieving this goal, that's what we're trying to achieve.
Over the last few years, the City of Salisbury has noticed a significant increase in the number of new and emerging communities coming into the city. The City of Salisbury is a target settlement area for the Department of Immigration, and over the next few years there will be a significant increase in new and emerging communities coming into the city as well. As part of the sports development framework, we wanted to provide opportunities for people from these new communities to get themselves involved in sport and recreation in Salisbury. There were two key activities the City of Salisbury were looking for from the Salisbury Link Coming Together Through Sport program. One was to provide opportunities for our local sporting clubs to become more culturally aware of the new and emerging communities coming into the City of Salisbury. And two, we wanted to engage new and emerging communities and invite them to participate in sport and recreation. To achieve this, we undertook the following programs. Cultural awareness training for local sporting clubs so that they could start understanding a little bit more about the countries and the culture that the people coming into the City of Salisbury were from. We also wanted to understand, I guess, the barriers to participation in sport and how clubs could learn from that and engage new and emerging communities to participate in sport. Building partnerships with local communities and local organisations so that we could then welcome and invite people from new and emerging communities to get involved in sport and recreation. Six local sporting clubs participated in the Salisbury Links Coming Together Through Sport program. We had the Redbacks Basketball Club, we had the Salisbury West Netball Club, the Ingle Farm Little Athletics Club, the Salisbury Karate Club, the Parafield Gardens Soccer and Sports Club, and the Para Hills Lawn Bowling Club. To celebrate the success of the Salisbury Links Coming Together Through Sport program, the City of Salisbury hosted a Harmony Day event at the end of the program, where the opportunity for clubs to come to St. J's Recreation Centre and engage in a cultural, you know, festival of music and food and also sporting activities was provided to them. It was an opportunity for people from new and emerging communities to integrate and engage with people from our local sporting clubs. There were a number of key successes of the Salisbury Links Coming Together Through Sport program. Some of the key successes included participation by local sporting clubs in the Salisbury Links program, and their passion to want to provide opportunities for people from new and emerging communities to get involved in sport and recreation. We're able to build a number of relationships and partnerships with local community groups, and that will continue to grow as we move forward as a council. The Bhutanese community have developed a very strong relationship with the Parafield Gardens Soccer and Sports Club, in that up to 80 players are now participating through the club. The community has engaged. There are a number of volunteers and coaches looking to get involved as well. And the Parafield Gardens Sports and Social Club has embraced that and participated by providing coaches and support and helping them to integrate into their local sporting teams. The Salisbury Link Coming Together Through Sport program has now come to an end. However, the City of Salisbury will continue its work in building relationships with new and emerging communities and identifying opportunities to integrate them into local community sport.